Subscribe to Business of Cinema. Click the bell icon for all updates.
Generally, filmmakers are very selfish and they want to make maximum mileage of any film. But in spite of the fact that Bahubali has become such a massive hit of the century, you never thought of selfishly making 3 or 4 parts instead of coming up with Bahubali, the conclusion in the second franchise itself. That's one question. And second question is, will you ask Anil Thadani to release the Bahubali part 1 again so that people who have missed out, very few, to catch up with that and then see Bahubali 2?
Yeah, now the second question we'll now ask now itself, sir. So are we going to release?
A week earlier, we're planning to release the film.
Thank you. We are planning to do the same in the southern states as well. We want to do that, really the first part, 1 week or 2 weeks earlier, whichever is the best thing to do so that people, like you said, I think very few people missed on it, but just to get them back into the narrative, we thought we will release it in the the first part again. And sir, I'm very, very selfish. I'm not an unselfish man. I want my film to do well. I want my film to gather lots and lots of money. But the same time, we also know it's not good to kill a golden goose. You know, we know how to extract the maximum out of it. It doesn't mean killing the goose. But and also to add it, the films, the story which we started is going to end with Bahubali Part 1 and Part 2. But the world of Bahubali is not going to end. We are going to continue in comics or novels or virtual reality films or TV series or animation. The world of Bahubali is going to continue for the fans to enjoy.
Mr. Rajamouli, this was actually that you answered part of my question, which was whether it's going to be a franchise. Is it going to be a movie franchise? Because, you know, given how much we are now competing with Hollywood and, you know, the big Hollywood franchises, does it make sense for, you know, a hugely popular story like yours? It lends to a really Indian movie franchise. Have you thought of that?
Actually, ma'am, what I really, really believe is that we should have a very, very good story,
yeah,
at the base. That story should drive us to do anything, whether it's a film, whether it's a virtual reality film, whether it's a comic, whether it's this thing, whether second part, third part, tenth part, or whatever, or ending the film there itself. It is a story that should drive everything, not the market. We should first find the story, then create a market for it, see what's the market, try to enhance it. But just because the market is there, we try to push something which doesn't have soul, I don't think it will last long.
Karan, yahan pe. Akshay Kumar aur Rajinikant ki jo aane wali film hai, they have sold their satellite rights for 110 crores. So do you think that, you know, star power matter?
Huh?
Kya hua, samajh mein nahi aaya?
Sorry? yes. of course it matters. Where are you, my dear?
Yo.
Where? Yeah. Hi. Yeah. Hi. Yes, of course star power matters. And I think that the coming together of two humongous stars from two different parts of the country coming together in a huge film will definitely make the satellite money exciting. And also it seems to be a humongous mainstream film. So of course stars matter. I mean, we should all know that by now, living in the country we do.
This is for the producers. From me. Here. This way. Here.
Hi, Bharti.
Okay, hi. This is for the producers. Is there a figure you can give us for the final budget of the film? And how much did you make with the first one? How much do you expect to make with the second?
They don't know yet.
No, I'm sure they've got a figure.
Lovely, Bharti. You've become a chartered accountant now. You want all
married to one.
That, well done. Pramash. I don't have those figures. You have to ask the producers.
Well, the first part, we didn't make any money. That much I can tell you.
How is that possible?
Because
Karan made money.
I'm a presenter. Presenters always make money. The ones who really put their hard work, blood, sweat, and tears into it, sometimes they don't land up making money. But you know, the equity the film has raised is beyond even the monetary worth. But I know, I would understand why you want a technical, but I think you're getting nothing from this panel.
But Karan, does the presenter not
finished? He has finished. He's going to tell me.
Yeah, the second one, we will make a lot of money, which will compensate for what we didn't make in the first part.
Yay.
What's the budget?
Yay.
What's the budget?
Budget of both the parts together is in the range of 400 plus crores, around 450 crores.
Thank you.
Karan, does the presenter not share the royalty?
Sorry?
Does the presenter not share the royalty?
We share love, ma'am. We don't share anything else.
Okay, one question to Prabhas. Prabhas, did you break your bones this time?
No.
Last time you were like,
yeah,
you know?
Yeah, last time.
So what was your experience this time with all that stunts and actions, you know?
Yeah, actually this time Rajmouli took a lot of care of me. Like he planned very well, and even the action scenes, we had a lot of action scenes, but still he edited the action scenes before everything, most of the film. And I think second part was much, much, much more comfortable, and Rajmouli especially took a lot of big care.
Prabhas, beech mein Rana ki film aayi thi, The Ghazi Attack. Aapne bhi kuch Hindi ya Bollywood ki filmon ke liye plan kiya hai ya kuch scripts pe baat chal rahi hai agar aap share karna chahe?
Yeah, if something like that, I'll let you know next time when we meet.
Rajamouli sir, after the release of Bahubali 1, a lot of trolls were made on social media as to why Kattappa killed Bahubali. So what was your reaction initially, and did those trolls create any pressure to, you know, focus more and make the second part more larger?
The amount of trolls that you get on your film is directly proportional to the craze that you have on the film. That is what I believe. So then whether it's good or bad, however people discuss, if the people are discussing a lot about your film, that means that it's made a lot of impact on them. So that is how I view it. No, it doesn't create pressure. It gives me a lot of confidence that so many people are going to watch my second film on the first day of the release. It guarantees openings.
We have last two questions, ladies and gentlemen.
Okay, I wanted to ask one more.
Yeah,
again about figures, but different different kind. Prabhas and Rana, you have fantastic physiques on the screen. Is that computer generated or is it for real? And how will we know?
Are you serious?
Yes, I'm serious. I'd like to know.
Well, I had no job. Both of us had no jobs for about 5 years except training and looking like what we look in this film. Ma'am, it's not computer generated. It's human generated. It's pretty real.
You, Prabhas?
Also, speaking for the both of us.
For him.
So, Raja, okay, sir, we a have question to you here.
Yes.
Raja, sir.
You need proof.
You need proof?
The 28th of April, ma'am.
All will be revealed.
Raja,
pun
sir,
intended.
On your right, Raja, sir. Sir, right here. So, we saw the trailer, second trailer. Raja, sir, here, right, on your right.
Yeah.
So, there's a scene which is similar to Hercules, sir. Dwayne Johnson, where he's coming with the open arm and the bows are coming to him, sir. So, there are few more scenes also that have been similar to another movie. So there's a scene in the trailer that has been, he's standing with the open arm and bows are coming to him. So it's the same scene from Hercules, Dwayne Johnson's. So
you felt like that? Did you feel like that?
So kind of, sir.
You kind of? So yeah, you watch the film and let me know. See, when we make war films or when we make any kind of action films, and there are so many shots like arrows coming, bows shooting arrows, or horses coming, or elephants coming. It's the same kind of war. War is the same. How you put your shots through it, is matters. If you think one arrow shot is looking like the same thing here, I feel funny actually answering that question.
Rajamouli sir.
Okay, that's the last question, ladies and gentlemen.
Okay, I have two questions. First is Rajamouli sir. The Tamil version of the trailer was leaked. So would there be any kind of measures that you would be taking to battle piracy, you know, when it comes to the movie release?
There are two things here. One is leakage and one is piracy, but both are completely different. Piracy happens when someone, after the release of the film, someone captures it in one mode or other and puts it online and make money out of it or they don't, whatever. That is piracy. Leakage is something when during the film, someone inside the crew, someone inside the studios, or someone captures and puts it on the social media or whatever platform just to the fun of it. Both are completely different. And this particular thing is neither. It is some technical glitch in the Facebook. The video, which is supposed to be in the private mode, went into public mode. We still exactly don't know what is the reason, but it changed the plans. But anyway, we are happy with it because the kind of response that we got, we are very happy with it, and fans are really, really happy because I always tend to postpone the date. I always tend to come later and that I came much earlier than what I said. They are quite happy about it. So all is well that went well.
My second question is to both Karan and Rajamouli, sir. The attack which happened on Bhansali, sir, you know, again for the second time, do you think it's sad that, you know, filmmakers in today's time have to face these kind of attacks often and there's nothing that one can do?
I have gone on record and spoken about what happened with Sanjay, and it's deeply saddening to me as a filmmaker, as a human being, as a citizen of our prestigious and wonderful country, that we have to kind of endure something like this. And my thoughts, my support, and all my ideologies are with Sanjay. It's deeply saddening. What do I say? Every time I read something like this, it really saddens me. And I feel like we, on our level, between the Producers Guild, we've sat down. We're all in support with Sanjay and his entire cast and crew. And I hope that adequate measures can be taken, that something like this would never happen to another filmmaker again in our land.
I completely agree with Karan on that one. Any artist, filmmaker or not, a musician or a writer or anyone, he should be have, whether that's good or bad, we don't know yet. First thing is, we don't yet know what Mr. Bhansali is going to present. And even whatever his presence is not in tune with the people's thoughts, he's an artist. He should be able to express his views. The freedom of speech is one of the fundamental rights of the people of this country. He should be able to express, any filmmaker, any artist for that matter, should be able to express his views.
I have a question. Karan, towards your left.
Ladies, thank you. Thank you, I'm very well, thank you. I'm doing very well and the babies are doing really well. Thank you so much for asking. Ladies and gentlemen, on that note, I'd like to call this to an end, and thank you so much. From the bottom of our hearts, the entire cast and crew of Bahubali and all of us in Mumbai, I really thank you for your enormous presence. And one second.
Mr. Karan Johar, from Mr. Rajamouli and team Bahubali, we have probably the most iconic piece from this film that we want to present to you. Oh. So please, this is the sword that Kattappa killed Bahubali with.
Oh! Okay, so now I know what my kids are going to inherit. Beyond my equity as a filmmaker, it'll be this sword, which will be worth a huge amount, I think, in years to come. This is amazing. Thank you so much.
Again, thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you on behalf of all of us.
And truly honored to be here and to have you in such enormous presence. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
tomato.
Hi everybody, I'm Shahrukh Khan and watch me only on facebook.com/businessofsinema.